So you're ready to go ahead and start your first Discord server so you can start to build a community. But I know it can be a little bit intimidating. I know that I felt intimidated when I first started to create a Discord server. So I wanted to make it extremely easy for you here today. So that way, by the end of the video, you have a Discord server set up and you know how to go ahead and fill it with people. So what I've gone ahead and done for you is I've created a template that you can go ahead and download in the description of this video, where I've done a lot of the heavy lifting for you by creating your channels, making it look professional. And then all you got to do is make a few tweaks that I couldn't do in the template because it needs to be done on your side. I'm going to walk you through that step by step. And then it's super important that you stay around to the end, because after we set up the server, I'm going to show you the three things that you need to do to start filling your Discord with people so that way you actually grow. So let's go ahead and get started. Click the link in the description of this video, and that's going to bring you to a page just like this. This is going to ask you to create your server based on my template. So the first thing you want to do is you want to decide on the name for your community. Now, you can change this at any time, so you can just pick something for the time being and also add in your image, add in your logo, and this is what's going to be the name of your community. Once you've done that, you're simply going to select create, and that's going to bring you here where you'll see here that I've created a lot of the things that you'll need to go ahead and get started. Of course, you can remove things that doesn't make sense. You can add more things. The goal here was to give you a template that you can get started with and feel comfortable inviting people to today. So the first thing you're going to see here is welcome. This is going to say start here, rules, introduction. You'll have an announcement section where you can provide updates, events. You'll have updates from Discord directly. You can then share your live stream, posts from your social, clips from your streams. And then here's where your community is able to kind of engage. You have access to a general chat, memes, anime, TV movies, show off your pets, FPS squad, RPG crew, cozy gamers, share your setup, clips, gaming challenges. I wanted to try to give you a little bit of everything because everyone is different, and I wanted to have something that would fit your needs and your style, and then you can kind of tweak it based on what you're looking for. And then you'll have some voice channels to be able to have your community members be able to engage and have conversations. And then here is a private mods only section for you as the admin and your mods to have conversations, to talk about the community and things of that sort. Again, you may not have no mods at the time being, but I wanted this template to be able to grow with you and have that section available there. So the first two things I want to show you is just how to navigate the template and how to make some adjustments before I show you how to be able to add a few rules, add a bot that's going to help you with some stuff. And then we'll talk about how do you get people into your Discord once you have it set up. So the first thing that you're able to do is if you come here to the top, you're going to see where it says server settings. So the first thing that I want you to look at is roles. So roles are the roles that your community members are going to have. So moderators will have the mod role, you know, you as the admin will have the admin role. And then right now, the one that I added here for you is new members. This is where you can then start to add additional roles based on your community, maybe on levels. Maybe you want level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4. And these roles allow you to decide what does that member get access to. So for example, if I have a mod with a mod role, they're going to be the only ones to be able to see these mod channels, right? If I want to only have people with the role Cozy Gamers see the Cozy Gamers channel, then I can go ahead and do that. And you can have your members pick the roles that fit their needs, so that way they can also customize the look and feel of what your Discord community looks like on their end. Then you can come here to the actual sections, let's say Community Hub, and you can right click here, edit category, and you can go ahead and have specific kind of permissions for that individual. So let's take a look here. This community hub, I want all new members to have access to it and be able to communicate and engage. So to be able to do that, we'll click this little plus icon, hit new role. We'll select the new members. We want to make sure that they are able to see the channel. We don't want them to manage the channel. We want to leave that opportunity for admins and mods. And then we want to be able to make sure they can send messages. They can send messages in threads. They can go ahead and embed links. Now, again, if you don't want them to embed links, then you can go ahead and leave that off. You can allow them to attach files. And again, you can just kind of go through here because, again, this is your home. This is your home for your community. So you can kind of dictate what access you want your community members to be able to have. Do you want them to be able to send voice messages? Do you want them to be able to create polls, right? Do you want them to be able to have the opportunity to do voice channel permissions? And just look through this step by step. Each section has a description on what it is, and you can decide on what you want them to be able to do. Then you can hit save changes, And now what's going to happen is that anyone who has the role of a new member is going to be able to do all those actions that I just given in these individual channels. Now, you can decide to edit one channel specifically and come to permissions and say, you know what? I don't want new members to be able to have this. I just want my subscribers for my YouTube or YouTube members or my Twitch subscribers or my Kick subscribers to have access to clips. So then you can create a role, give them that role and give them permissions. And then now they'll be the only ones to access this channel. Again, my goal here is to get you started, to give you a place and a template to begin this process of building your community. And then as you start to kind of grow in Discord and grow and get familiar with it, what I like to call is you can take little side quests and be able to go and find videos or research on specific things that you want to do, because everything you're able to do in Discord is all about your creativity. And if you want to do something creative, you can go ahead and do that. But my goal here is to get you started and not get you stuck on the first part, which is actually building the actual server. So now that we have the server set up, what we want to do is we want to go ahead and install a bot. And this is going to be carl.gg. And I wanted to go ahead and find a bot that didn't really cost money. Now, there is, every bot has a premium version to it, but Carl bot has the most free options available. Again, because you're just getting started, you want to have something that helps you grow the server but doesn't cost you any money in the beginning. But eventually, as you grow, you're going to want to invest in bots that allow you to do a little bit more, because again, your community is super important. It contributes to a lot of the growth that you're going to have as a creator and as a streamer. So what you're going to do is, and again, I'll put a link in the description to the Carl bot so you can go ahead and follow along. You're going to select login with Discord. This is then going to ask you to get logged in. Once you've gone here, it's going to ask you to pick your server. I'm going to pick my server. And now you're going to see here that I'm going to give it permission and hit continue. I'm going to leave everything checked here because it is a bot and you do want it to have access to everything that we have. We're going to click skip here for a moment, and this is what you're going to see. Now, this can be a little bit intimidating as you're looking at this because there's just so much options, but I'm just going to draw your attention to the most important thing, which is when somebody joins your server, you want them to look at the rules and accept the rules to then automatically get the role of new member where they see the whole community, because you don't want people coming in here and kind of spamming and going through that process. You want to add a little bit of friction for them to be able to join, right? So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to come to where it says welcome. Okay, so anytime somebody joins your server for the first time, you've probably all been a part of Discord servers where you'll see that when you join a Discord, it says, oh, so-and-so welcome, or so-and-so join the Discord. You're going to want to put this in a channel like you'll see here that I've put that is not really bothersome for people, right? So new members that join will show up here. So that way me and the mods can see who's joining, but then everyone else is in the community can't see who's joining until they actually start engaging and communicating inside of the Discord server. So what we're going to do is we're going to select the channel, right? So you're going to scroll down and you're going to select the new members channel. You're going to hit save, and that's all you need to do for this section here. Now, we want to be able to add a reaction role. So what a reaction role means is that this bot is going to automatically assign the role new member to every person that joins your Discord so they can see the rest of your server. So we're going to create new reaction role. Okay, we're going to select the channel and we want to select start here. Then as far as the content goes, what you're going to want to do, and again, I'll paste this in the description of the video here below, but what you want to do is you just want to copy that and you want to put in welcome to, put in your server name, and then this is a space for let people know what this Discord is all about. I've already predefined some rules here for you, but feel free to change them if you want. And then it's going to say here, react with check below to agree to the rules and unlock the rest of the server. So super important here. Again, until a member selects this check mark, you're going to see what I mean here in just a moment, they're not going to be able to see the rest of the server. This ensures that they see the rules, understand what your community is all about, and they kind of stay within those guidelines. Okay, so that's super important to be able to kind of keep in mind. All right, so now once you've done this here, we need to add an emoji. And what emoji did we say here? We said the check mark. So we're going to select the check mark here, and then we need to assign the role that we want to give. Again, if you decided to keep the new members role for the beginning, that's totally fine. If you decided to create your own roles, you would just select whatever role you want to be able to have here. And then here at the bottom, only allow members with this role to be able to pick up roles, right? So we want to have that there. We want to go ahead and hit create, and you're going to see here that this is now going to go ahead ahead and create this embedded message directly in our server. And then once you've gone ahead and hit create, if we come back here to Discord, you're gonna see here that now our car bot went ahead and added in this information. So here's what I mean when somebody joins your server for the first time. This is gonna be the only channel that they're going to see. And then they have to hit this little check mark. And once they hit this little check mark here saying that they approve the rules of the server, they then are gonna get the tag new member, and then they're gonna see the rest of the information here. Now, if you're having a little bit of issues and like CarlBot is not posting the information in here, one of the things that you want to make sure you come do is come to server settings. You want to come to where it says roles, and you want to make sure that you have CarlBot all the way at the top. This is how you will make sure that the bot's able to come in and post things on your behalf. Now, here's a cool thing that you can do inside of the bot. If you come here to where it says bot settings, you can change the name of your bot again to add a little bit of personalization. So I'm just gonna say Curry Bot. I'm gonna hit apply. And if we come back to Discord, you can now see that says Curry Bot. It says Curry Bot. And again, it just adds a little bit more of a personality directly here to your Discord. So now that you have this here and people are able to now join your server, this is super important where now you wanna start understanding how do you invite people in. So to be able to invite people in, you wanna come to the start here. Okay, you wanna go to invites and we want to go ahead and hit create one. Then you want to hit edit invite link. This is super important here. Okay, expire, you want to hit never, but the max you want to put it at 100. Now, I know it can be a little bit tedious, like, hey man, after I get to 100, now I got to make a new link. Yes, 100%. The reason why I say not put no limit is because you don't want to get a bot attack. And what that means is that people can come into your server, send tons of bots, and if you don't cap that invite at 100, it can be thousands and thousands of people that get into your server that are bots, and you want to be able to prevent that. 100 is a lot easier to manage. So what you simply want to do is you want to hit never, you want to hit 100 uses, and then you want to hit generate new link. Then you're going to see here that you have 0 out of 100, and this is going to be your link here for you to be able to go ahead and utilize. So once you have that in place, now you can begin to start inviting people over to your Discord. So again, right, you'll come here to create new one, you want to go ahead and hit copy, you can edit this link here. Again, we want to put it at never, we want to put it at 100 users, hit generate new link, hit copy, and now you're good to go. This is the link that you can now start sharing with people so you can start to grow your server. But now that your template is done and ready to go ahead and start inviting people, how do you actually get people to come into your server and actually stay? So let me walk you through three things that you can do to start achieving that, okay? So the first one, okay, for you to be able to start doing this is, guess the number one is, you have to tell people about your Discord. Okay, you have to tell people. And there's three ways for you to be able to do that. So the first way is through content. Okay, this can be through your YouTube videos, this can be through your short form content, this can be in your content where you tell people in the description, like I did here today, where I show you there's things in the description for you to be able to download. This can be in the middle of your video where you invite people to join your Discord. Say, hey, you want to join my Discord? There's a link in the description of this video for you to be able to join. So that's going to be the first way to be able to do that. The second way you can tell people is directly through your socials. Okay, so on your social media, whether that be on Twitter, whether it be through your social content, in your bio, you can let people know that you have a Discord that they can go ahead and join. Then the third way is, of course, in your streams. Now, there's three different ways for you to be able to do this in your stream. So the first is during. Okay, so you can tell people during your stream to come in and join your Discord so they continue to connect with you. You can do it at the end. Okay, when you end your stream, say, hey guys, my stream's over. I want to be able to now send people over to my Discord community so that way next time when I go live, I have more people to be able to join because I don't want to depend on the platform notifications to let people know that I'm live. Okay, and then the third thing is using a bot. So you can use a chat bot like Streamlabs bot, Nightbot. I have a video on my channel on Nightbot, so which is a bot that allows you to be able to automate messages, help you with management of your chat. And I'll put a link to that video in the description here. But what you can do with the bot is that every 15, 30 minutes or 45 minutes, the bot can send an actual message in your chat that says, join the Discord. And you can get people to come and join that way. But okay, just telling people to join your Discord is not enough. Okay, in order for you to get them to actually click the link and join, you need the second step here. Okay, so the second step is you need to tell them why to join. Okay, why should they join your Discord? This is super important. And there's three questions you need to answer here. Okay, the first is who, the second thing is what, and the third thing is why. So let me show you an example of what I mean by this, okay? So you need to make sure that when you tell people to join your Discord, that in that invite, you answer these three questions. So what, who is this Discord for? What is the Discord about? And why should it matter to them? So if I'm gonna invite people to my Discord, I'm gonna say, hey, if you're a streamer or a content creator and you wanna be able to grow, I encourage you to join my Discord server where we have opportunity to be able to collaborate together. You can get feedback on your content, figure out strategies and ways to be able to grow, right? And that's kind of the reason why you wanna be a part of that. So again, I just told you who it's for, streamers or content creators or gamers, right? What is my Discord about? It's about collaboration, connecting with other streamers who are on the same journey that wanna be able to grow. You get strategies, feedback on your content, like there's a reason why. And then why does it matter to them? Because if they want to grow, they want to be around other people who want to grow and can keep them accountable on this journey, right? So it's super important that you don't just tell people join my Discord, but you tell them why they should join your Discord. Okay, now just because you tell people to join Discord and you tell people why they should join doesn't mean that they're going to stay. So what you want to do is the third one is why should they stay? Okay, why should they stay? There's three reasons why people stay inside of Discord. And if you can accomplish these three things, you're gonna build a thriving community, okay? So the first one is they need to be heard, okay? Second thing is they need to be seen. And the third thing is they need to be valued. And you may be saying, how do I accomplish these three things here? So being heard means that you incorporate the community in the things that you're trying to do, whether it be coming up with the game that you're trying to play, ideas that you have, conversations that you want to have. Again, keeping people involved in the discussion in your community makes them feel heard, like they're a part of the community. Okay, seen. This is super important. Easy way to make your community feel seen is like when they join, have them introduce themselves. And then when they introduce themselves, have everyone in the community or even yourself welcome them in. Say, hey, welcome. Super excited to have you here. Oh, that's awesome. Relate with them, right? You want to be the person that's guiding the conversations and making people feel like they join the community that they feel a part of. Remember, you already did a great job by telling them about the Discord. You did a great job on telling them why they should join. They actually join. Now make them want to feel welcome and make them want to stay. And then making them feel valued. This is valuing their input, valuing the things that they share, valuing their concerns, valuing the things that they bring to the community, whatever their skill set is, whether it's somebody else who's gaming the same game as you, somebody else who's really good at art, whatever the case may be, you want to be able to get to know your community as much as you possibly can. And then the biggest mistake that most people make, especially new streamers and new gamers and new content creators make when making a Discord, is that they feel that 1 to 10 people is too little. Right? And here's the big mistake that you make. Thinking that, oh, you know what? I'll get serious about my Discord when I get to 100 people, when I get 300 people, when I get 400 people. Oh, it's just 5-10 people in there. It's cool. I don't got to be engaging with them. I don't got to have these conversations. That is the biggest mistake you could ever make, because these 10 people, if you love on them, that's my interpretation of a heart. If you love on them, okay, they would be the ones to bring in your next 20, your next 50. Okay, because they're going to be the ones to be the foundation. You want to use those 1 to 10 people to get to know them, to understand what's working, to help you mold what the community or the Discord server looks like. Because then what it does is that if they're a part of the community and they make the community experience good, the next person that joins feels welcome and sees the community and they see the culture that you're building. So again, don't discredit the amount of people that you're getting every day, every week, every single month. Because I say this all the time, if 200 people pulled up to your house right now, unannounced, you would get overwhelmed, right? But a lot of times we forget that each individual viewer, each individual person is a real human being. So again, love on each individual person that you have and you'll see consistent growth inside of your Discord. But okay, what if you don't have nobody watching your content? You don't have nobody watching your streams. So how are you gonna even tell people about it? How are you even gonna tell them why they should join? How do you even get them to actually stay? So I want you to go ahead and watch this video right here where I teach you what I would do if I started streaming from zero so that I can grow my community and grow as fast as I possibly can, even if I was starting from zero. Click that video right there and I'll see you guys in the next one.